Hello, Narnach here. Welcome back to Grim Dawn. We are playing our hardcore demolitionist, a retaliator. Last episode, we found ourselves a shiny new ring, the incorruptible imperial ring, that bumped our ether and chaos resistance enough so they are now both capped. Ether is at 83 and chaos is at 80. Technically 1% over the max. So our resists are now in a really solid state. We could do with a little bit more bleeding resistance. We have increased maximum resistance, so we actually need 17 more points to max it out. And on the cold side and the vitality side, we could also do with a couple more points. But the most difficult to max resists are now maxed. So that bodes rather well going forward. That said, we are now going to deal with a bunch of cowboys. And they are not really chaotic. The possessed ones might deal with a little bit of ethereal damage down the line. Well, in the bigger picture, things are going to be pretty darn okay. So, for this episode, we're just going to push forward, get to the next waypoint, which is going to be the other waypoint or the other camp of the rovers. Also, Helmain over here is on fire today, 4 levels above us. But after the initial burst, our life is looking pretty good. So, we'll just adopt a wait and see attitude here. We are getting close to leveling 74, which will be the last level where we need to put a point into Demolitionist. Then that class, or that mastery rather, is maxed. It's also the last time, of course, that we're going to get some life and some stats from that. After that, it's only going to be skill points that will be spent on skills, not to improve our survivability. Upside, of course, is that we will be investing in boosting our damage from now on out. So with a bit of luck, we might actually end up killing things faster. Oh no, someone dead, and they got a skeleton with him. Actually, they got 2 priests. That solves it. Once the priests are down, the others mostly tend to vaporize as well. Ah, yes, bug territory. I have to admit, I do enjoy killing wasps. Also, there's quite a bunch of them. But no, they're nice, they're uncomplicated, they do decent burst of damage, but they don't really have a lot of life. So they are very good at suiciding themselves. But the thing is, they are like kamikaze pilots. They hurt a lot. So my health went down a lot more than when facing anything before that. So be on the guard here. But how many queens do we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, there's too many colors here. I can't even count the queens now. That's 1, 2, 3. Yeah, there's 4 heroic wasps here. That'll get you going. We might be maxed out on resists now, but have no mistake. This game is pretty good at actually just throwing a whole bunch of things at you. But we've dealt at least with all the add-ons. So that means at this point, it's only going to be the heroes to deal with. But I got a feeling once we take down the regenerator, that things are going to be mostly under control. But yeah, they've demonstrated they can deal damage. That's, they got my respect. This is an unexpected burst of excitement. So I was definitely not expecting the wasps to just hit this damn hard. Hey, there is a blue there, sharpshooter's glass eye. But another, oh, there's only one remaining. We can basically go back to the snooze fest, but it took four heroic wasps, as well as a whole bunch of suicide add-on wasps to do a boatload of damage to us. Alright, let's have a look. What did we harvest? We got the Amarestan Pauldrons. That has a Nightblade sound to it, and indeed, it's a soldier and Nightblade. So bonus to physical and piercing damage. Chance to avoid projectiles, some bleed resistance. Yeah, it's all good. Sharpshooter's glass eye. That sounds demolitionist. Indeed. Part of the sharpshooter's mark set. Four-parter. This gives extra pierce damage, bonus to pierce damage, some health, some offensive ability, plus two to explosive strike and some elemental resist. So, not bad. Also grants you glass eye, it's a range with two-handed weapons, passive bonus. Oh wow. That's actually pretty cool. Just get bonus fire and piercing damage as well as 30% pierce resistance as just a passive bonus. I like it. I approve. And then we move forward, because of course we haven't murdered enough bugs yet. Let's see, any of the wasp nests, because they really blend in well with the background. Okay. As long as they're regular wasps, we should be fine. Okay, yeah. See, once we really get a good hit in, they just explode. And that is level 74. Excellent. So just take a nice step back here. Demolitionists, one more point. That maxes us out. Unfortunately, there's nothing over here that's actually useful for us in terms of final skills. But on the soldier side, we're gonna get another point into Cadence, which is gonna boost our damage. Physique grants us a little bit more life regen, so that's all good. Damage per second, almost 6000 DPS. Which probably isn't a whole lot in the big picture, but I think it is about as high as we've gotten with this build, so I'll just be happy and pleased with that. Okay, you can just follow me. Okay, then over there, that's just gonna be another yellow queen, okay. Sure. Yellow ones, they hang around a little bit longer. So there's always a guaranteed unique here. I think there's always the purple queen, and there's gonna be another heroic. Yeah, there's the purple queen. No extra heroics. Okay. Well, we did get the motherload outside, right, with four of them. So maybe they're just all out of heroics. And then we wait. Should go slightly faster now, of course, with plus one to Cadence. Oh, this is yet another one of those mobs that can actually be stunned, so don't blitz it. At least it seems like she can be stunned. Because a very distinct lack of attack. Yeah, she's got a cycle of like... yeah, 2-3 seconds, then she keeps attacking. It's pretty slow. Unfortunately for us, that's really not what we want. Eventually, the queen will go down. The Grand Queen. Hey, and almost there. Okay. Wait, was that a purple? Or am I imagining purples now? Okay, I think I was imagining a purple drop. Too bad. Imagine purples. Those are the worst purples. Anything else? Not really. So we risked our lives and all we got was the two blues outside. From a fairness perspective, the most of the risk definitely outside that fight with the 44 heroics definitely was the most dangerous fight, and we did get a larger reward than for the inside. So risk versus reward was actually pretty darn good for those fights. Oh, two of the three heroics. Okay, let's just overguard this. There's still a bunch of the small ones that also really, 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 really want to get into the fight, but unfortunately they are just not capable of doing that. Funny enough, they keep getting just locked up in the obsidian cage. That legendary has been serving us really well, the obsidian devil's cage hauberk. It's one of the first uniques or legendaries we got, and now it's still with us. It's still good. Okay, I think a fourth heroic might have been the tiebreaker here. But this is, despite them looking big and mean, they're actually not all that scary, unfortunately. Oh, there we get a purple, the guillotine, which looks like a two-handed axe. So that's unfortunately not gonna be relevant for us. Two-handed axe for plus one to all the skills in soldier and shaman. Ooh. If we had gone warder, we might have found ourselves an endgame weapon. Well, it's two-hander, and of course we don't use that. Revel in death, 20% chance on enemy death. 1 second recharge, 6 second duration, 100% increased bleeding damage with 50% increased duration, and 25% chance of 50% of attack damage converted to health. Wow, that's quite a lot of sustain that you get. And it's a buff that's effectively just gonna refresh itself. As long as you keep killing, of course. Okay, fancy. Fancy, fancy. The journey continues. We got ourselves a legendary. In this case, the effort reward was just completely random. There was no reward for danger. Okay, this. Aha! More peoples with more quests. And this is the waypoint.
Keep your weapons where I can see them.
Hello, you're a little bit grumpy. Let's see, Shrine of Mock Dragon. Got some injured people, and I can do a thing I can do to help. Here's your royal jelly. Gets us a waypoint. So, Rover's Reputation, that's useful. Royal Jelly Ointment. This might be the third tier of the royal jelly, because I do have the first tier, second tier, and then this is going to be the third tier. And we get some of that stuff as well. Nice. So it's always nice to just have stuff that you can just give it up. And now we have to slay a troll. So, yeah, indeed. This is just the third type. So the base one is 25 life, then you get 12 life, and then you get 20 life in the end. I think at this point it might be useful to simply just keep this one running at all times. So we just keep this one as the... I was gonna actually try to click this one. Yeah. So we just keep one of the flasks up and burn through the lower tier ones, and then we just keep the high tier one. Okay. Well, I just want to just sell some of the yellow items just to keep things slightly manageable. I must say, money is actually starting to pile up. There's not a lot of places where I'm spending it on right now. There's some items that definitely could do with a little bit of an upgrade. But on the whole, doing pretty good, pretty fine actually. Let's see, we don't use exalted scepters, we don't need new gloves, we don't need worse a helmet. And in terms of belts, yeah, can't really argue with a legendary one. So, have to admit, sometimes there are yellow rings or belts or amulets that actually have quite a collection of stats to them, but the green ones always tend to have more. So yeah, even when I actively just go out of my way to look for some yellow stuff, green is just better. Hello there, troll 83. You are meant to be a challenge, aren't you? Okay, so let's see, how much does he hit for? Okay, overhead smash, 2,500 damage. Keep in mind though, we have 2,500 effective armor on average. He missed. What is his hit chance? He's got an 85% chance to hit. We have a 75% chance to hit. Yeah, definitely offensive ability is not our highest stat. Also helps with damage output, of course. If you can hit things, then that's pretty good for your DPS. On the other hand, as long as the foes are actually pretty decent at hitting us, or at least not critting us, but regularly hitting us, then we can just retaliate and we will be fine as well. But on the whole, no, imagine if you're playing a caster and you've got maybe like 5,000 life, and you don't have 2,500 armor, but maybe close to 1,000. This guy will be hitting you for 4,000 or more, and on 5,000 life, that is 80% of your health. So pro tip, probably for casters, get more life. And armor, it's useful, even though, well, for casters, you really need a hefty investment in order to make that work. Because most of the time you simply don't have the physique. Okay. Yeah, let's disassemble some forges. Let's wait, that's not gonna be here. Actually, slightly on the wrong way, aren't I? Because we just head over here. Dynamite, that is useful. We've gotten the quest from the inventor in town to actually give him some dynamite, and now we can also blow up epic items in exchange for rare crafting materials. At some point he gives that. Okay, pathing here is a little weird. Okay, now it's okay. There's a dude in here, that's always fun. Boris, master of the pit. Upside of Boris is he is a pretty decently fast attacker compared to some foes, so this fight is actually in our favor. So why are they... Yeah, okay, now they died. I was wondering, they were throwing bombs and they didn't seem to stop, but they just needed a little bit more of encouragement with damage reflection. But boys, yeah. I think I'll take your title now. Excellent. The Vanguard of the Legion. Wow, that's a shield. 35% chance to block, that's pretty darn low compared to what we got. Because we got 43. It does more damage, it blocks more damage. Slightly increased block recovery. It gives us a boatload of health. It gives a defensive ability, ether resist, chaos resist, elemental resist, and plus one to all the skills in a soldier. This is pretty darn sweet. It's actually gonna cost us some lightning rest because we have a lot of lightning rest on the current shield. It will make sure that our cold is gonna be capped out. Well, fire is already in the realm of the ridiculous. That's just only gonna get more so. But this will also overcap our chaos and ether resist, so we can actually maybe shuffle some other things around. And a plus one to all skills and soldier is pretty potent. This is gonna be worth considering. Let's go with that. But for now, let's simply push forward. Hello, Frankie. What? My side, what's your outlaws? Why should I spare you? Okay, I'm listening. Wait, so get out of here. Okay, well, we're generous and we could have killed him, but well, I think enough people have already died at this point. Might as well spare a couple lives. Be nice. Not entirely sure if I made the similar choice on the way through previous difficulties, but well, arbitrary choice is arbitrary. So what's happening here? This looks like it's blocked in some way. Oh well, doesn't really matter. So there's a forge, that's nice. Ooh, next to the dynamite, that's a nice reward for that. So how are we in terms of... Cool, because of course we are getting the experience here simply by killing all of these cowboys. So if you combine that with just solving a couple of these quests, and I think there's a pretty decent chance of getting to revered or maybe needing only like one or two bounties to actually get to it. But for Grimdawn, I generally, when I'm farming areas, I only do it for specific crafting materials because I really want to make something, not necessarily for the faction experience. Though, yeah, killing the cowboys is effectively the only reliable way to get faction reputation with a town, with Devil's Crossing. Because after this area, you simply don't see any more of these cowboys. Whereas, beasts are in the entire game, the ethereals are in the entire game, Cotonians are pretty much in all aspects of the game. Hello there. So, we just kill one of the forges, that's good. So then next up is going to be to tag the waypoint, and then I think we have done enough for the episode. The next episode we can dedicate it entirely to chasing down Darius Crondley. Got a feeling this is also going pretty well because this is once again it's a pretty aggressive melee fighter, and those are the things we kill best. Actually, this is almost pacifist level character. No, where enemies don't die if they don't attack you. With the exception of Cadence and, well, Blitz being a bit aggressive, but... We are definitely stronger against things that really, really try to murder us. And we are a lot weaker against things that don't try to murder us.
That skill's not ready.
Okay. It's another forge, just in case. Might as well murder it. And I don't think there is any other heroic foe in the area. Just some yellows. And there we are. Ah, there you are, another one. Asher the Wolferel. What would it be pronounced as Ash? Ashay. Ashy. Well, let's go with Ash. But yeah, the wall is blocking, but going down pretty darn quickly, I have to say. Also, it's not really knockback resistant. Which, from someone being described as the wall, you would expect them to have stun or some form of stun immunity. Just to keep the illusion of it being a wall just up better. There we are. And then that is the entrance that gets us to a little waypoint. So anything we still need to report back to town. Yeah. Oh. Oi. Guys, can't you see I'm trying to decide where I wanna go? Yes, thank you. Oh, and we have to head back to Quaid before we talk with anyone here. So I think we will meet Elsa later on. It's, I don't know, the whole deal with Elsa is the guy in Devil's Crossing, he's really desperately looking for her. Then, no, you go through the entirety of Old Arkovia, and then I think after Old Arkovia, or after you defeat Cronley, you find her, and then she's like, yeah, I don't want to be found. Okay, she doesn't want to be found, and that's kind of it, and... I don't know, it always struck me as a little weird. Either way, the forges have been destroyed, we get some rover reputation. And then now we have to assassinate Moneybags Martin. So... That is gonna be for next episode. So for now, as always, I'm gonna thank you very much for watching and hope to see you again next time. Bye bye.